Jason. You see, Jason was my son, and today is his birthday.
For all things Halloween, this is Hauntformer, and welcome to my Friday the 13th special. The Friday the 13th film series is a very interesting case in the world of cinema. Debuting in 1980, the original slasher Friday the 13th was a very simple concept. A crazy mother goes on a killing spree after the death of her young son. But with this film came dozens and dozens of sequels and even a remake in 2009. So because of this very popular series, I am going to rank the original span of the Friday the 13th film series, starting in 1980 and ending in 1989. Now I know, there's other Jason Voorhees movies out there. There's Jason Goes to Hell, there's Jason X, there's Freddy vs. Jason, and the 2009 remake, but I want to focus on the original 8 films of Friday the 13th, the films that came out in the 80s. So I'm going to rank those films, and of course, this is all my opinion, so you're going to have a different opinion, I can guarantee you that, from my own. But I want to hear your thoughts in the comments below. This is just my opinion, and also remember that there are definite spoilers ahead. You've been warned. So if you haven't seen these films, go watch them, pause this video, and then come back and watch it and see what you think about my rankings. With all that being said, we are going to jump into ranking the Friday the 13th film series. Kicking off the list in our last spot, number 8, goes to... Friday the 13th, Part 7, The New Blood. Now I know I'm already going to be hearing groaning in the comments. Hauntformer, I like Part 7. And I understand where you're coming from. This movie is very unique, very different. It has a telekinetic girl that visits Camp Crystal Lake, and throughout the film, she has to battle with not only this crazy doctor, but also Jason Voorhees himself. It's a really neat premise. There's also some cool shots involving her telekinetic powers at the lake. And Jason is one of the coolest looks in the series. He looks awesome, especially unmasked at the very end. I also love Kane Hodder's dedication to the role throughout the film. He takes a lot of beatings in this movie, especially towards the end of the film, but he does an amazing job with the stunt work. But I can't just rank the last half hour of this film. I have to review the entire movie. And the first major chunk of this film is a lot of boring character stuff. And I'm fine with character development in a film, but really, a lot of the characters go nowhere and end up getting killed by Jason anyways, which is pretty unfortunate because I want to see some character growth in the first half of the movie, or at least understanding some of the characters, their motives, and where they're coming from before Jason arrives. But that being said, I didn't see that a lot in this film, and while, again, it is a pretty good film in the last half of it, I didn't really care for the entire film as a whole, and it definitely wasn't as enjoyable as many of the other sequels on this list. But that being said, again, Kane Hodder was awesome, the soundtrack was great, Jason looks incredible, but again, it was a little too slow paced at the beginning for my liking. But that being said, we are moving on to number 7 in this list, which goes to... Friday the 13th, Part 3. Or Part 3D, whatever your, you know, whatever floats your boat, I guess. Friday the 13th, Part 3D is the third installment, obviously, in the franchise, and was shot in 3D. This is also the film where Jason Voorhees dons his iconic hockey mask. You see, one of the characters, Shelley, brings the hockey mask because he's into pranking people, and there's a little storyline going on with him throughout the movie. The characters were a little more likable in this film, you know, than some of the other ones, like Part 7, and you know, I kind of felt for some of the characters throughout this movie. The soundtrack was definitely interesting, and the last, you know, couple minutes of the movie are definitely intense, and there's a lot of Jason action. But the film just didn't feel like it met its potential. There's more that could have been done with this movie, and I didn't quite see it. A lot of the setups in this movie were also made just for the 3D gag. There's a lot of scenes where the camera just lingers, you know, so you can see, like, ooh, the end of a shovel in 3D, or the end of a machete. And, you know, while it's kind of cool in 3D, if you don't have the glasses, doesn't really make a lot of sense. So, you know, because of the slow character stuff, you know, throughout the movie, and not really seeing Jason all that much until the very end, Friday the 13th Part 3D gets this rank at number 7. But moving on to number 6, we have... Friday the 13th Part 4, Hauntformer, are you going crazy? Well, a little bit, potentially. I know, a lot of people consider Part 4 their favorite of the franchise, and I can definitely see where they're coming from. The special effects work done by Tom Savini is fantastic. I think it's one of the best in the entire franchise. I also think Jason is very, very cool towards the end of this movie. And the whole plotline with Tommy Jarvis is one of the best throughout the franchise. He's one of the only characters that actually survives to live to the other films. And I really like his development in this movie too. But that being said, Jason isn't in this movie all that much. He's kind of hidden, you know, with that POV shot that they like to do in the first Friday the 13th, which, in my opinion, was kind of unfortunate because this is the third movie with Jason and the fourth in the series. By now, everyone knows that Jason's doing this. Why is it a mystery? I'm not so sure. I know it's maybe more horror-themed than a lot of the other sequels. You know, it's definitely more serious. But in my opinion, the Friday the 13th series is about having fun, and while I did have fun watching this film, there are more that I had more fun with. So that being said, Part 4 gets this rank. Number 5 is going to... the original Friday the 13th. The one that started it all. Starring Pamela Voorhees as the killer, though she's not really in it until the very end, but it's definitely an amazing performance. I do love that the whole setting of this camp feels very real, and though the, you know, budget was like $100,000, which is barely anything, you know, it has a certain charm to it being so low budget. It has a real interesting aesthetic to it that I really do enjoy, and it definitely screams Friday the 13th. The acting in this film, you know, while it's not the best, obviously, for such a low budget, it's actually not that bad, and the characters are pretty likable throughout the movie, so it's kind of sad when Pamela Voorhees, you know, ex-nays them, takes them out, if you will. But the whole setup of this movie is very interesting. It has a nice mystery feel to it, and at the same time delivers on the ending and sets up one roller coaster of a series. Moving on to number 4, we have... Friday the 13th, Part 5, A New Beginning. Now, I know, a lot of people aren't a big fan of this film, and I can understand why. Jason isn't the main killer, some of the scenes are kind of slow, the acting could be a little bit better, but actually, I enjoy this film quite a bit. I think it's relatively well-paced, you know, from the very beginning you're getting an interesting story, following Tommy Jarvis going to this camp, because, you know, they think he's going crazy because of his incident he had back in the day with Jason. He's having nightmares that Jason's gonna be resurrected and try to kill him somehow. And, you know, of course, a lot of people, you know, say, but it's not Jason in the movie. And I get that, but you have to remember, this film is very similar to the original in the fact that there's a copycat killer, or in fact, a killer that isn't Jason, that is disguising himself as Jason Voorhees. He's actually a paramedic named Roy Burns, who after the death of his son, that also attended the same camp that Tommy's going to, he goes on a killing spree and tries to frame Jason as the killer, when in fact, it's actually Roy Burns. And if you think about it, the story is very similar to the original, a parent who goes crazy because of the death of their son. You know, you can see the parallels there. But, you know, in terms of filmmaking, I thought it was very interesting. There's a lot of POV shots, like I mentioned, because this is more of a mystery, kind of like the original. But I think it's a little more entertaining and a little more well done. There's a lot more interesting characters in this movie. Some of them are more comic relief, some of them aren't. There's also a very interesting setting to this film, and the final climax of the movie when they fight Jason, Roy, is very interesting. I love the barn setting that it's in. It makes for a really cool movie, and also the soundtrack is really awesome too. With all that being said though, I know a lot of people don't prefer Part 5, but give it another watch. It's actually not that bad. It's more of an entertaining Friday film. Moving on to number 3, we're giving the spot to... Friday the 13th, Part 2. It's kind of weird when a sequel eclipses its original counterpart, but in the case of Friday the 13th, it works. It carries the same tone as the original, but gives us something unique, something different, and expands upon the characters, making them likable, making the setting interesting. I just thought overall, for the package, it was very well done. Jason Voorhees is finally the killer in this film, but instead of wearing a hockey mask, he's wearing a sack over his head, which honestly I thought is a pretty cool look. At the very end, you also can see his kind of deformed face, which is crazy. And what I really like about this movie is it introduces Jason's connection with his mother. Towards the end, you get that very iconic shot, which I thought was very well done. And, you know, the characters are more likable, like I mentioned. You really want them to make it out alive. But it's a Friday the 13th film, and a lot of them, unfortunately, meet their demise at the hands of Jason in very interesting ways. But I thought the final girl was very smart, very intelligent, and very likable, and she gets the job done towards the end of this movie. So overall, I think it's one of the better of the Friday the 13th franchise, and if you haven't seen it, you should definitely check it out. Moving on to number 2, I'm giving the rank 2... Friday the 13th, Part 6, Jason Lives. Now we're getting into the good territory. In my opinion, Jason Lives is one of the best Friday the 13th films because it takes itself not too seriously. It has fun with the Jason character. My biggest complaint with this movie is that a lot of the characters that get killed are, you know, just throwaway characters, or just introduced and in their same scene they die, which kind of was set up as a gag, which, you know, you want to take death seriously in a film, but I get they were trying to make the film more lighthearted, and even the soundtrack portrays it that way. But that being said, the main storyline with Tommy Jarvis trying to kill Jason once and for all, who was resurrected at the beginning of the movie, makes for a really interesting plotline, one of the best in the series. And overall, I just find the film more entertaining than a lot of the others. Jason looks really cool, and I'm glad to see that he's back, and there's a really awesome final confrontation that really makes the whole package really nice and neat. But that being said, there's obviously only one winner in this game, and while controversial, my number one pick goes to... Friday the 13th, Part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. I can hear you clicking in the comments already. Hauntformer, how could you rank this number one? Let me explain. A lot of people don't like Part 8. And the main reason is, though it's called Jason Takes Manhattan, he's barely in Manhattan, and mostly the movie is taking place on a cruise ship, on a boat that is sailing to the island of Manhattan. I hear you, I do understand. But just think of the film in terms of the entertainment value. Take aside it being called Jason Takes Manhattan. I know that had to do with budgetary constraints, with not being able to film in all those New York locations. But on the ship and on the island itself, this movie is the most entertaining, at least in my opinion, of the series. Similar to Jason Lives, it doesn't take itself too seriously and has fun with the Jason character while also trying to develop its own characters. I found the characters in this movie some of the most likable and interesting in the franchise. Of course, there are a few throwaways, like I mentioned, kind of like every movie in this franchise. But overall, the characters are enjoyable to watch, and Jason is my favorite in this film. He looks awesome, played by, again, the amazing Kane Hodder, who does some amazing work in this movie. There's also a lot of really interesting sets, whether it's on the cruise ship itself, or if it's on the island of Manhattan. That ending shot, you know, where Jason is in Manhattan, in Times Square, is just fantastic. And I know a lot of people don't like this film, and you know what? I perfectly respect your opinion, but in my own opinion, I find it pretty entertaining and a fun end to the 80s reign of Jason Voorhees. So, there you have it, my Friday the 13th ranking for my Friday the 13th special on Friday the 13th, the holiday, if you will, of Jason Voorhees. That being said, I'm wrapping up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And like I said, you probably disagree with my rankings, but leave your thoughts in the comments below. I would love to hear from you. That's all from me, you guys. Remember, as always, for all things Halloween, this is Hauntformer, and I'll see you in another video. Thank you.